ahead and look at you. I have a call to worship prepared, but you are in the sunshine with the color coming through and the light that's coming off the ceiling, the warmth of it on your faces. You are exquisite. Good morning. When Amelia reads the scripture this morning, it's going to begin with this phrase, pay close attention now. God is creating new heavens and new earth. To imagine the beauty in which you sit this morning, transfigured by something even better, even more peaceful and hopeful and loving, even more connected and sacred. Sometimes that's hard to imagine, but that is what we are about. In these moments of worship, we hold the heavens and the earth in our whispers, in our songs, and in our prayers, and we bring the sacred that we know to enhance this world and to wait for the wonders to come. Welcome to worship. Denise is going to light the Christ candle.
Once there was someone who said such amazing things and did such amazing things, people were always asking,
Lord.
And once he said,
I am light.
This is the light of God among us and within us and around us, ever moving, always present. Friends and neighbors, welcome home.
And we acknowledge with joy and with poignancy that we are located on Treaty 6 territory, a traditional gathering place for diverse indigenous peoples, including the Pepechase Cree, the Blackfoot, and the Nakota Sioux, also the Métis and many others. And among our neighbors, we weave our histories, our languages, and our cultures, influencing this vibrant community and bringing hope. Morning has broken, number 409 in Voices United 409.
Thank you.
Holy One, we bring the freshness of the morning, the brightness of the sun, the scudding clouds, the little bit of breeze that reminds us we are in an in-between time, warm for a moment with something else coming. And we acknowledge that we in our hearts are warm for the moment, and we don't know what is coming. We have plans, we have hopes, we have habits and rituals and expectations. And in all of this ordinary living, deep in our hearts, we cannot know. And so we bring you gratitude for the parts of our life that bring us security, for the people on whom we know we can rely for love, for a church in which we are always welcome with hope, with joy, and for this time, when we bring the honesty of our hearts, the gratitude of our souls, the weariness of our bodies, and the possibilities that you are still creating among and beyond us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Holy One, in our own in-between places, between busyness and the duties, between the sleeping and the working, between our efforts for others, and our wondering what else we need to do, slip the quiet prayers, the prayers that move around without words, the prayers that bring us energy, and the prayers that slow us to a stop. With poignancy, Holy One, we pray for all who are in hospital, undergoing treatment, in an in-between place, a body, or mind, or spirit, and for ourselves, in the mix of our living, worried and joyful, disturbed and reassured. Hold us well, for the in-between places, between our activities and our sleep, we rely on your love, your courage, your everlasting presence, not simply to get us through, but to keep us loving. Amen. Pay close attention now. The prophet says, God is creating a new heavens and a new earth. Pay no more mind to the chaos that went before, but live fresh
Thank you.
One of the things I love about the pleasure of sitting in my study through the week and reading scripture are the jokes that show up. You might have heard it when Amelia was reading. Fabulous reading. All the earlier troubles, chaos, and pain are things of the past to be forgotten. Look ahead with joy. Anticipate what I'm creating. No more building a house that someone else takes over. No more planting fields that an enemy confiscates. For my people will be as long-lived as trees. My chosen ones will have satisfaction in their work. Wolf and lamb will graze in the same meadow. Lion and ox eat straw from the same trough. And here it is, right? But snakes, they get a diet of dirt. Don't you love it? I mean, the people who write scripture are so human. We just get this wonderful vision, and there's just this little bit that we can't get over, which is very true to human nature. One of the wonderful things about being in a community of faith is that we get to explore human nature in all its mix. We come every week and we hear something in scripture that lifts us up and reminds us that somebody else has walked a rocky path before, that somebody else has had a song in their heart, that somebody sitting beside us understands what it's like to be living in a body that feels like lead. And someone else who knows the breath of the Spirit and the inhalation of joy. And in that mix, we live and move and have our being, and that's the way it's supposed to be. It isn't supposed to be perfect. And we do get that little moment of spite, humor, resistance. Snakes get to eat. Thinking about the peaceable kingdom in a time when we are increasingly, it seems, divided in our communities and across our globe is a bit of a challenge. Frankly, it's one of the reasons to keep showing up, is to remember that divisions don't have to be the way forward. And I offer to you that I agree it is a challenge to live in those divisions. To live reading texts from people that we thought were friends, saying, how could they possibly think that to be true? To find within ourselves changes that we think, what's going on? Why is it that I'm becoming more security-minded, less generous of heart? Why am I afraid? And when the sorrows of our lives deepen into our spirits as they should. When the grief that we carry from the loved ones whom we have lost is so heavy that our shoulders are burdened, our feet are sluggish, our prayers are silent, we wonder how it is that these hopeful words from the prophet Isaiah and so many of the other biblical speakers and hymn writers and, for that matter, our neighbors in church can possibly be true. Because the reality of living is that grief should stop us up. Our bodies should be heavy as lead. Our feet should be sluggish. Our prayers are often silent because the depth of our love is true. And there is nothing wrong with grief. There's nothing wrong with seeing that the world is divided and that there are many who are suffering. We ourselves often among them. These are fine and honest things. And God requires of us such poignant honesty that it is chilling. And in the mix of all of that, the peaceable kingdom. We acknowledge the precarious powers that we carry. The power that were standing, sitting at a meeting with people who have a common vision and no idea of how to get there together, because opinions are so strong and practices are so strong. And yet, when the moment of grace comes through and we realize that we can do it together, it's like the sun comes out. It's like the morning stars are sitting together. It's like the new heavens and the new earth. And you see, this is the thing about the mix. Scripture and the prophets in particular often speak in hyperbole because they had to speak so loudly to get somebody to listen. If the world around you is full of complication and violence and people torn one from another, then it's the hyperbole of poetry. My little sister is 11 years younger than me, so I can tell stories on her and not have to buy her ice cream the way I have to buy other family members' ice cream if I talk about them without their permission. That's in the long-term deal. My sister Susan is blonde, and she's taller than me, and she's really smart, and she does, for her entire career, she's been working in nonprofits in fundraising and development. She gets the reality of life, and she is a Maritimer. She lives in Hamilton. She cheers for the Tiger Cats, but she is a Maritimer at heart, and this is how I know it. It's because when she tells me a story, she says, "Catherine, I cannot exaggerate this enough." Chaos behind, all of the pain gone, all of the things that divide us melted away into forgiveness and vision. It's exaggeration, isn't it? And hyperbole, we can't get there yet. But he speaks of it as a present reality. I am creating, says God, a new heavens and a new earth. And frankly, we don't let go of all of the pain because there are parts of the pain that are rooted in such deep joy that we can't. And not, again, because that's a bad thing. Because, for instance, with the pain of grief, the pain of separation, it's rooted so deeply in love that the pain becomes bittersweet, doesn't it? It's bittersweet. And so we keep it. That's fine. But this hyperbole, this exaggeration, that there really is something to look forward to and that it is starting now? Well, now with the prophet Isaiah was a very long time ago. The people were in captivity, for heaven's sake. They had oppressors on one side and people beating them down on another side, and they couldn't go home and they missed their place and they couldn't get to the temple and they didn't know how to pray and they didn't know where their children were and they couldn't talk to their grandparents and they were torn apart. And in the midst of all of this, Isaiah comes in and says, God is even now in the midst of all of this anxiety and division, creating a new heaven and a new earth, something real, something amazing. I want one more thing for you to know before I move to the next thing, and that is that this is not revenge fantasy. Revenge fantasy pops up in scripture once in a while. There's a lot of humor in scripture, a lot of joy, a lot of storytelling, and every once in a while there's a little bit of revenge fantasy. Okay? And the snake eating dirt is not revenge fantasy. If you read some of the most beautiful songs, they go on with how God delivers us, and then the things God does to the enemies are unspeakable. That is not this. That is not a human being writing revenge fantasy. This is an acknowledgement that God is always present with us, no matter what. And in this mix of life and all this division and angst and pain and sorrow and guilt and warfare and violence and oppression, that God is creating a new heavens and a new earth, and that we are part of it. That we are not only part of it, but it's from the spiritual realm around us as well. This is what God says to Job. "Where were you when I laid the foundations of the earth? Tell me if you have understanding. Who determined the measurements of the earth? Surely you know. Who stretched the lines upon the earth? On what were the bases of the earth sung? Or who laid earth's cornerstone when the morning stars sang together and all the heavenly beings shouted for joy? Number 680 in Voices United. Pray for those who have been hard at work building houses and others have taken them over. We pray for those who have planted fields only to watch the enemy confiscated or worse yet burned it over. We pray for those who stand in horror as forest fires rage. Funny the violent language we use about nature. those who look at their own hands and their own energies with a deep desire for change. We pray for Race Course School, for the blessing of the teachers there, the adults who look after the children, the older children who look after the younger ones, the opening of minds, the possibilities that can be accomplished when people are safe and have enough food. We are grateful for the work there. Burn our prayers for friends and for those unknown to us who are on the run, moving away from trouble, looking for safety, seeking a community where dignity and respect will be the operative words. May we continue to learn how to be that and how to encourage that. Holy One, in the mix of everything, we take root. In your promise that your people will be as long-lived as trees, that your chosen ones will have satisfaction in their work, that before we call out, you answer. The trees and the hills will clap their hands, together with the angels and the archangels. The generations before us and the generations to come, that praise and wonder and joy and love and delight and laughter and fullness of heart and belly, release of all that is binding, freedom into all that is loving, in all of this, Holy One, we bring our prayer. Together in ancient words, we say, God of our life, there are days when the burdens we carry shake our shoulders and weigh us down, when the road seems dreary and endless, the sky is gray and threatening, when our lives have no music in them, and our hearts are lonely, and our souls have lost their courage. Flood the path with light. Turn our eyes to where the skies are full of harvest. Tune our hearts to brave music. Give us the sense of comradeship with heroes and saints of every age. And so quicken our spirits that we may be able to encourage the souls of all who journey with us on the road of life. To your honor and glory. Amen. The trees of the field shall clap their hands. 884. If you need the words, 884 and voices united.
Thank you.
It's hoped that we will hear in the singing of the spheres around you, the angels, the trees, the neighbors, the children, the sound of the memory of the loved ones singing, you will go, enjoy, and under your feet you will find peace. And it will be the sounds of hope that will carry you. Because these are promises from God. And God loves you so deeply that these promises are gifts.